Problem number 16. William put the tip of his pencil on the outer edge of a graph of the unit circle at the point 0, negative 1. He moved his pencil tip through an angle of 4 pi over 3 radians in the counterclockwise direction along the edge of the circle. At what angle of the unit circle did William's pencil tip stop? Okay, so first let's just lay out what our unit circle looks like. So the unit circle is a circle centered about the origin that extends, that has a radius of 1. So we're centered about the origin, and we have a radius of 1. So it's going to look something, this isn't a perfect circle, but I did my best. This point on my grid would be at 1, 0. This point would be at 0, 1. And these are x and y values. This is just ordered pair, x and y values. This point would be at negative 1, 0. This point would be at 0, negative 1. Okay? So these are our points. And in terms of the angles that each of these are at, so if we have here, this was the starting point, so we're at 0 radians, so 0 pi radians. If we were to have an angle of, so if we have an angle up to this point at right here, this is would make a 90 degree angle, or we say this is a pi over 2 radians, they mean the same thing. If we go the whole way around, we go halfway around the circle to this point, this would be 180 degrees, or we just call this pi radians. If we go 270 degrees around, or in radians, we call that 3 pi over 2, or we could say all the way around, this would be 360 degrees, or we say 2 pi radians. So these are just the markers for that. So it's saying that we're starting at 0, negative 1. So we're starting right here, and we are going counterclockwise. So we're going this direction. A clock moves, tick, tick, a clock ticks like this. So we're going counterclockwise. We're going the opposite direction. We're going like this. And we're going 4 pi over 3 in that direction. Okay. So 4 pi over 3 in that direction. So if I were to go 4 pi over 3, that means I'd be going 3 pi over 3 would take me, that's just 1 pi, that would take me 180 degrees. So that would take me to this point, to this location, that's 3 pi over 3, and I would still have 1 pi over 3 still to go. So if I went another 1 pi over 3, so right here I'm at pi over 2, but I'm going an extra 1 pi over 3 from there. So I'd end up somewhere right about here. It would just be basically pi over 2 plus that 1, that pi over 3 we still have left. Okay, and then just to make these, I could rewrite these with common denominators. This would become pi over 2 would become 3 pi over 6. Pi over 3 would become 2 pi over 6. I just, you know, multiplied this one by 3 over 3. I multiplied this by 2 over 2 to get common denominator of 6. Add these up. And I would be at 5 pi over 6. That would be this location. My angle here would be 5 pi over 6. And that's answer choice B.